Hello, I present the Whistle Patwin 29 bike. It's ordinary budget mountain bike with 29-inch wheels. It has an aluminium frame, basic Shimano Acera 3x9 drivetrain, and in this case, even 2x9. Coil spring Acer Santor XCM with 100mm of travel, with lockout lever and basic Shimano brakes. Parts like stem, handlebars, and the seat post are products of Bite Company. This model also has Schwalbe Rocket Run and Nobby Nick tires. As you can see, the bike was in average visual and technical condition. And now, what I have changed in it, and what in my opinion has the greatest impact on how the bike rides and looks. If you have similar bikes which are worth about 300-400 euros, it makes no sense to invest in them lots of money. Framing this bike is heavy and does not have the latest standards, like true axles or tapered head tube, and it's not any unique high-end model. In such ordinary bike, for average rider, in my opinion, the most important thing is that the owner should not get tired and suffer from riding and from looking at such a bike. With a small budget, I believe that the first thing to do is to take care of the contact points between the driver and the bike. So a good saddle. I installed proven and comfortable Kalis driveline. Grips are durable and soft Audi long neck. For pedals I choose HTPA 12 with cartridge bearings. In order to change the position to a more comfortable one, I used Kalis handlebar with 50mm of rise. The second most important element are the contact points of the bike with the ground, so the tires. I'm not a fan of Schwalbe, so instead of them I use fast rolling Continental Race King tires with pure grip compound. To further reduce the weight of the bike and increase its durability and simplicity, I installed 1x9 drivetrain and changed the crank to the first generation of XT760 cranks with Halotech 2 technology. After this changes, the weight of the bike dropped from 15 to 14 kilos. Of course, the whistle had a general service and the ride on it changed dramatically. Now the 50 kilometers and longer trips is no problem, but a pleasure. Most things which I took off the bike were sold to increase the budget for new parts. The final version of this bike cost about 400 euros. Of course, if someone wants, he can invest much more in such a bike. But in my opinion it makes no sense and it will not pay off. If you are planning to buy a bike which you want to upgrade in the future, it's wiser to get something with newer and lighter frame but with low spec parts, and then successively change them and make bike better. Thanks for watching, and if you have any questions feel free to write it in the comment. And if you like the video, drop a like and subscribe my channel where I publish new movies every Monday and Tuesday. See ya!